Form Swift is really primarily a legal, tax, and business document creator, but it does have the ability to edit PDFs. And it does says it's absolutely free, no sign up required, but you will see at the end otherwise. One nice thing about the editor was that before you used each of the tools, you had a brief GIF tutorial how to use it. So that was very helpful. Once you are ready to edit PDF, you can select the file or drop it into the editor, and then you can zoom out to see it better, and you will be able to see all the pages, but there is no option to reorganize or delete the pages. At the very top, you have all the editing options. Once you want to add new text, you click on Add Text, and you reposition where you want to edit. Now you can start typing, and you'll be able to change the font, make it bold, italic, and colors. Now the customization options are very limited because there's only like 4 fonts and 8 different colors. So not likely you're going to be able to match the styling to your current PDF. If you want to change the text, you click that option and you're able to change the text in your PDF. So that's really helpful, but the customization options are limited also. You can't add links or remove links and so on. And let's say if you want to remove a watermark, I was able to click on it, but I was not able to remove it. It would just make a copy of it, so you're able to cut and paste text, but you can't remove watermarks. Now, form editing options, you can really just basically add the text into the text boxes and check marks and X's. Now, it was very sensitive throughout the whole process. Whenever I clicked somewhere, it would try adding new text. If you want to add the check marks and X's, you have to kind of click and resize it to make it the size you want it for the check mark or X. But for some reason, I just kept clicking and creating new text boxes. To erase thing, you're basically just creating a whiteout. You're creating a white box that covers anything in your PDF. The same thing with reduction. It's creating a black rectangle that you can resize it to your needs. However, this is not a good protection for very sensitive information. Someone with a good editor will be able to get to that text. The highlighter works the same way. It's a transparent yellow rectangle that you can resize to your needs, but there's only one color. And if you want to add images, you can select an image, reposition, resize it, but that's it. You can't rotate it, you can't change its opacity and layer it, and definitely you cannot edit or remove the images currently in the PDF. To add signature, you click on it, and there's two different ways to add signature. You can either use your trackpad to just sign, and that would be placed in your document, or you can just use the other option when you type in your name and the script font can be added as a signature. Now there's only one script font and there's only one color, so that's the limitation. Now I was trying to find a way to reorganize and delete pages, but there is no way to do that. And once you're ready to download the file, you can click on it and it will ask you actually to create an account, which is fine, I could do that, but then it told me there is a free trial, but otherwise I'll pay $8 a month, which is reasonable, but there are really limited options. And now even if I wanted to try the free trial, I could not do it without providing my credit card information. So I just decided against it. If you do sign up for an account, one nice thing is that actually it does save your documents that you worked on under My Documents. So thanks so much for watching.